guys, it's Billy. Hope everybody's doing well during this crazy time we're going through right now. I figured I would use this time to make a few videos, catch up on watching a few videos. It's been a couple weeks since I've really been able to watch and especially comment. I know I've said this before in other videos, but I've gotten really kind of lax on my comments. I watch a lot of my videos on the phone, and that process, the app or whatever, just makes it almost impossible to watch a video and leave comments. You can't pause the video or rewind the video while you're making a comment. It makes it almost impossible to comment. So my intentions are to watch a video on the phone and then go back and comment later, but a lot of times that doesn't happen. So what I'm doing now is I'm just going back for the last couple weeks and trying to catch up on comments and some of the videos I may have missed. So please don't take it personal if you don't see a comment from me on a video. Those of you that I watch on a regular basis know I'm watching your videos and I try to comment when I can. And I know you guys do the same, so it's always greatly appreciated. But let's get to the steak and taters, if you will, of this video. So this video is the Wall of Cassettes. This is something that I've been talking about for quite some time, had intentions of doing for quite some time, but it has just taken a little bit of planning on my part, because I'm not the handiest of guys. You know, I could have done this all by myself, but I don't keep power tools like that. I mean, sure, I have a cordless drill and things of that nature. I even have a hammer drill, you know, so to get into the walls and drill into concrete and things like that. But I don't have circular saws and table saws and all that good stuff. My brother-in-law actually came out and, you know, I drew up these plans. I've been wanting to do this for quite some time. I saw LJ do something very similar and basically took notes from that and ended up making my own Wall of Cassettes that kind of filled the space very nicely with what I have to work with here. You see, kind of arcs over here. We have a radiant heater down here in my listening lounge or the music room, the man cave. I have radiant heat down here. We have it throughout the house, but we have the big radiators. It's baseboard heat throughout the rest of the house, which is nice. It's kind of non-obtrusive, but we have these big registers down here in the basement, so I had to work around that, which it actually worked out really well. I have two nice long pieces on each side, and then this nice big piece in the middle. It works out well, so I keep all, this is all my metal, hard rock and metal over here. All the country is over on this side over here, and then everything else falls in between. It works out very well. That's just kind of the way I listen to my music. It's pretty much rock and metal, country, and everything else. So it's just an easy way for me to identify with everything. It works out for me. I know everybody does things different. But anyway, we ended up, like I said, I came up with the plans. I drew up the plans, measured out the space, roughly figured in how many cassettes I needed to store. And thankfully, because I had all my cassettes in storage for so long, they were just boxed up. I wasn't able to really enjoy them. But I kind of estimated how many I had. Thankfully, I overestimated, so I left some space, as you can see, for growth. There's room for growth on each side. And then when I went through, I had several duplicates. So some of you guys may have seen some of the VCLT videos or, you know, stuff like that from, I sent a few things to Brandon. I sent a few things to Dan Powers. I sent a few things to Frank at Channel 33 RPM. As well as a handful of others. So if there's guys out there that, you know, guys or girls who are really into the cassettes and the cassette culture, let me know. I still have some things. I would be more than happy to trade back and forth, VCLT, whatever. I was just planning on, I want to definitely make sure they go to a good home. I could always put them up and sell them, but what fun is that? You know, I'd much rather trade with you guys or something, build some sort of rapport or relationship. So hit me up on Facebook or Instagram or Discogs. You can click on, go to my profile here on YouTube and just, you'll see my Discogs information. Shoot me a PM over there. I know YouTube makes it really, really difficult anymore to shoot direct messages to anybody. But, you know, like I said, I came up with the plans. It worked out good. I'm going to insert at some point throughout the video, I'm going to insert kind of the progress. I was able to take some, I kind of thought ahead and thought, because normally when I do these projects, I'll just hammer through them and I don't document them. I just get them done. It's like one day it's there, one day it's not there, the next day it's finished. That's the way you guys see it. But I actually documented the process here, going through the wood, cutting it, painting it, you know, sanding it, painting it, finishing it, putting it up, categorizing everything. So I'm going to go ahead and insert some of those photos right now so you guys can see it. Here we go.
But playing together like good friends should. Bob the Builder, can we fix it? Bob the Builder, yes we can. Time to get busy, such a lot to do. Building and fixing till it's good as new. Bob and the gang have so much fun. Working together, they get the job done. Can we build it? Can we fix it?
Yeah!
Bob the Builder!
Can we fix it?
Bob the Builder!
Yes, we can!
So that kind of gives you guys a little bit of an idea of how things went. You know, the layout is pretty simple. Like I said, I've got my country stuff, this is my hard rock and metal all the way on that side. Country is over here behind me, and then everything else here. A couple nice, cool little things. My Sony Walkman, an original Sony Walkman there. These cool headphones. Nice little Radio Shack component there. And then even my, this I thought was really cool. This is a TDK compact mini headphones in the case. Out of there so you can, well, it's actually sealed up. I was going to open it up to show you, but very, very cool. There you go. Now you can see what I'm talking about. There, got that glare off of it, but very, very cool. And then, of course, I've got my my Walkman CD. It's Willie Nelson. All my brand new blanks are, you know, back here in the back. I've got a whole ton of Type 2 cassettes that I used. Show you here. Got some there. So I've still got a whole ton of sealed. Which these things are going for crazy, crazy money now. Anyway, a whole bunch of those that I will eventually get around to making mixtapes or... you know, dubbing something over that maybe I'll rip from an LP or something like that, or even go digitally, something new that might be probably the best idea, something that wasn't released on cassette. It's, you know, when you've got a really good player, a really good tape stock, and you throw a nice high-resolution digital source on there and play it back on a really nice... system, man, it sounds phenomenal. Just great. So that's probably what I'm going to end up doing eventually. I do want to show you a couple recent pickups that I have had on cassettes here real quick. When I was in Nashville, driving through, coming back from spring break, I stopped in and saw my buddy Chris Hansen. I just shot him a message, you know, over What Lurks on Channel X. Tongue twister. Anyway, shot Chris a message on my way down, and he wasn't able to get together, but shot him a message on the way back through. I was like 90 minutes outside of town. I think I was coming through Murfreesboro at the time, and I wanted to stop by Phonolux and would love to see him. So he met me at Phonolux and ended up picking up this while I was there. I told myself I wasn't going to dive into the cassettes while I was there because I was on a pretty limited budget. I already spent a bunch of money in Florida, as you guys saw in my previous videos, but had to grab this for $3. Steve Earle, Guitar Town, just a beautiful copy of that. They actually had two copies of this, and I ended up grabbing the cleaner of the two. But there's the shell. Fantastic, fantastic album. And then speaking of Chris, you know, Chris had sent me, I guess it was a mixtape for a video that I think Andy Borders did. It was a contest. Make your mixtape. You know, back in the day, we used to always make mixtapes. And Chris, as well as Richard, I can't even remember the channel name anymore. Everybody changes channel names so much, it's hard to keep up with. But anyway, Chris had sent me a copy of his, and it was Mosh It Up mixtape, Volume 1. And he actually went to the trouble of creating the label and everything. Just some killer, killer stuff on here. It's on a Maxell 60 Minute. Cool little sticker. Chris, the thing I love about Chris is the little personal touches there, man. He did it right. But man, what a killer set list on here. I mean, you've got Slayer, Metallica, Death Angel, Exodus, Testament, Nuclear Assault, Anthrax, Overkill, MOD, Celtic Frost, King Diamond, Sacred Reich, and Flotsam and Jetsam. Mosh It Up. Thank you for that, Chris. That was unbelievable. A great surprise. And I play it. Matter of fact, I'm going to play it today. I'm going to play that in Anthrax, Attack of the Killer Bees. I just finished watching Chris's video, his Anthrax ranking, studio album ranking, and it was great. Kind of inspired me to pull out the Anthrax Attack of the Killer Bees, even though, you know, that is not one that is a studio album. You can't classify it as a studio album. So many B-sides and some live cuts and things like that. It's definitely probably my favorite Anthrax album as well. I've been looking for it forever on vinyl. It's impossible to find on vinyl, especially a nice clean copy. So I'll have to settle for my cassette copy for now. So if you see that pop up in your feed, if you're friends with me on Facebook or Instagram, you know why. Thank Chris for that. And then lastly here, one that I just picked up. This is Lana Del Rey, Norman effing Rockwell. I'm trying not to cuss too much on my channel anymore. I know there are some kids that watch, but even though it's not content made for kids, there are some people that just don't enjoy it. But, you know, sometimes I might let something fly. But you guys know what that's about. But anyway, check out this cassette. That's a ton of tape in there, kids. This thing. So here's the story on Lana Del Rey. I am super late to the party on this. And anyway, I was talking with my daughter, who has the adjacent room, and she at least streams her music through a Harman Kardon speaker that she streams through. And so she's at least hearing music the way it was supposed to be heard, not like through a little bitty headphone jack on your phone. And I'm kind of intrigued by what she's playing. It's very good. So we're just talking, and I'm listening, and I'm paying attention. And a couple songs in, you know, maybe two or three songs in, I ask her, I'm like, what is this? And she's like, oh, it's Lana Del Rey, Norman effing Rockwell. And I'm like, you know, I've heard a lot about that. It actually made, I watched a lot of everybody's top albums of 2019 rankings, and it made a lot of those lists, and it was just one that kind of just was off my radar. I totally wrote it off as bubblegum pop and things like that that I just never have been exposed to it. And once I heard it, I was like, this is good stuff. So I went to the record store before they actually closed everything down here in Illinois last Friday. I guess they did it on Saturday. So last Friday, I went to the record store to pick up a couple things, and I wanted to grab this album. And he's like, he kind of jokingly said, oh, you ought to get it on cassette, haha. And I said, they really released that on cassette? And he's like, yeah, well, absolutely. And so it was just quirky enough that I thought, you know what, I'm going to grab that on cassette. And I'm glad I did. This is one of those moody, ambient, just great, great albums. I'm so glad I got into this. And I'm going to dig into it a lot more. I've only listened to it like two or three times. But so glad I picked it up on cassette as well. So what I also want to do, guys, is I'm going to cut here. I'm going to show you the system real quick and then cut right back. Because everybody always wants to ask, well, what are you playing this on? You playing them through a Walkman? You playing them through a boombox? What are you playing them on? No, thanks to Bill, Helmet Diggy, for a heads up on an eBay auction. I was actually able to score a killer deck last year that I've been eyeballing for quite some time. So I'm going to cut to that right now and let you guys take a look at that. Be right back. So there's the cassette deck that I'm playing through. It's the Nakamichi RX-505. Just an unbelievable deck. Like I said, I ended up getting a heads up from Bill, Helmet Diggy, on an eBay auction sometime last year. And just love this deck. There's the Nakamichi. Have always really, really wanted a really nice Nak deck. And, you know, it's true. When you, because I was playing through, you know, some Denon. I was playing through Sony, a Pioneer, Maxell. I mean, I've had them all. But when you play through a top-notch, top-of-the-line deck, the stuff sounds so phenomenal. Just I've never heard cassettes sound so good. They're pricey, but once it's set up and maintained, it's well worth the investment. And that's what I consider it. I mean, I consider it an investment in me, an investment in my my listening pleasure. So, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. This is something a little bit different. Hopefully, I'll have a little bit more cassette updates to do. Maybe I'll go through and pull some of the stuff. As I was actually going through and categorizing everything, you know, I entered all this into Discogs. It was really, really great to be able to do that. I realized, man, a lot of my collections are kind of lacking, and especially my Kiss. You know, we get to where we collect so much, whether it be CDs, 8-tracks, cassettes, reel-to-reel, vinyl. You tend to confuse formats, you know, you get them mixed up. And that's what the beautiful thing is about Discogs and having that app on the phone is I'll be in record stores now. Perfect example, when I was in Florida and Georgia a few weeks ago, I was able to complete my Rodney Crowell discography by just picking up two albums. I knew. I saw something. I'm like, man, I don't know if I have this. Get on the app. Nope, I need this one. And I come home and I'm like, oh, it's complete. So I realized that my Kiss, my Lynyrd Skynyrd, well, my Lynyrd Skynyrd not so much anymore, thanks to Brandon for hooking me up with a killer VCLT on some original, super nice OG Lynyrd Skynyrd. We don't call them pressings. What do we call them? We've said pressings with vinyl for so much. I guess it's run, first run. I don't know. If it's something different, we'll figure it out. We'll figure it out together. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope everybody's staying safe, taking care of yourself, and taking care of one another. We're going to get through this. It just might take a little bit of time. But guys, as always, thanks for tuning in. Until next time, take care. Peace.